I love my dog, but he sheds a lot. And I found out the hard way. Look at that. Look at that. Guys, I swept, like, I kid you not, 2 days ago. Like, I know it seems like I'm faking it, but I'm not. That for real is 2 days worth of hair. He is shedding like crazy. Yeah, you look at it. You did that. You did. Sadly, I am not going to give you the answer that you want. There is no magical cure for dog shedding. Any healthy, normal dog will shed, and the frequency and the amount that your dog sheds is really dependent on its health and also its breed. Many dogs will shed or blow their coat in the spring and in the fall, but there are also dogs that will shed year-long too. Dogs that are inside for the majority of their day are more likely to shed throughout the whole entire year, unfortunately. Now, if you have a hypoallergenic dog, kind of like little Colin here, so a dog with short, curly hair, typically called hypoallergenic dogs, know that that is a myth. There is no such thing as a hypoallergenic dog. These dogs, they will still shed. It will just be a lesser amount, so you won't notice it as much, but they do still shed. So this is a problem that everyone's got to deal with. Shedding in dogs is a natural occurring thing, so we all just better get used to it. Shedding is the process of losing lost or damaged hair. So humans do this as well. I know I shed a crazy amount. You can always find my weird blonde hairs all over the place. It is a naturally occurring thing, and dogs, they will typically shed in the spring and in the fall. So in the winter, they typically will grow a really thick winter coat in order to keep warm in the winter. And then in the springtime, they're gonna shed that to make way for the warmer temperatures. So in the fall, it's gonna be the reverse process. Shedding is completely normal for dogs, so there is no need to worry. But an excess of shedding could be a sign of stress, poor nutrition, or medical problems. It can also be a skin allergy or skin parasites, so you do need to monitor your dog to see if it's a normal amount of shedding or if it is excess. Low quality dog food can make your dog lose its fur. So make sure that you're feeding your dog the highest quality of dog food that you can find that gives him all the minerals and the vitamins that it needs in order to be healthy and strong. If your dog is losing fur, it may be signs of an underlying medical problem or an allergy. So a dog could be allergic to any number of things. It could be food, it could be the shampoo that you're using, it could be cleaning products in your house, or it could be a pest bite on your dog's skin. Also, a hormonal imbalance, so your dog could have hyperthyroidism, or a pregnancy or lactation that can also cause hair loss in your dog. Most shedding is completely normal, but if you do notice that there's any kind of bald patches on your dog's fur, then you do need to go and check out the vet. Also, if your dog's fur is brittle or sensitive in any way, then you should probably schedule an appointment to get that checked out, just to make sure that there's no other medical problems or anything that's going on with your dog. So now, assuming that your dog has a normal shed, you are gonna need to up your grooming routine. That means brushing your dog every single day, which I know may seem like a lot, but I promise you, the more fur that goes into the brush and into the trash bin will be less fur that is on your couch. Also, bathing your dog regularly during this time is really, really helpful because you're just increasing the chances of getting all that hair out of your dog so that it doesn't go in your clothes. Invest in a sticky roller for your clothes. If you are not a big fan of fur on your furniture, fur on your furniture. Was that why furniture is called furniture? If you hate fur on your furniture, then try to cover it up with something, whether it's a blanket or a cover, just to make sure that your dog does not go up there. And if your dog happens to go up there, then the fur will not stick there because you got that covering. Try to protect everything as much as you can while your dog is in shed, because that hair gets everywhere and it does not come out. Thank you for watching. I hope that this video was valuable for you. My dog Django, this is not Django, this is Colin. My dog Django sheds year round, so I definitely feel the pain that y'all are going through. Basically, apart from the things I mentioned above, I just never buy black anymore. Like, I've just accepted the fact that I am always gonna be covered in fur, whether I like it or not, and that's just my life. That's what I've chosen, so. Make sure that you subscribe to our channel if you haven't yet already, and stay tuned for more dog-related videos. And we will see you next time. Bye.